Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, how you folks doing? Welcome here and welcome to another edition of the CMU. I'm your host, Conman167, and oh my everyone, it is a special Thursday night edition of this show. It never happens, and I mean never happens, but it's happening today. WWE Crown Jewel was earlier in the day, and it pushed our stream back till now, but we are live, and it is the go-home show before CMU Halloween Havoc in 1 week's time. Let's do this thing, everyone, because it is time for your Conman Certified Roll Call. So who do we got in here today? We have Falcon, how you doing? Cole Mario is here. Raul Kapar, Hot Sauce Herald. Ryan Vasquez, how you doing? We have Ross Blocks, Samuel Vlogs, Shane Bailey, Blake Lewis, how you doing? I see Trey Licato. I see Christian Vega. Nice to have you. We have Reth Solins up in here. King Chase, nice to have you. Casey Wood, how you doing, man? Jonathan Farthing is in here. We have Reth Solins, Lux7, so many great people. Everyone, it is time for the most outdated intro on YouTube. It's time for the CMU. Let's do it. And now, if you guys don't know how the CMU chant goes, it's as simple as this. You type a C, you type an M, and you type a U. What does that spell? CMU. Cock your fist while you're doing it. Here we go. CMU. 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 Let's get it. Welcome to the CMU.
Shane, Luck, Christian, tonight I'm caving in all three of your skulls.
Whoa, what? Okay, that's a little aggressive.
The following contest is a no disqualifications match. And it's for the WWE Television Championship.
Hold up, everyone. We have the TV title kicking off the show, and it is going to be Raul Kapar. No disqualifications going after the TV title. But let's dial it back here for a second. Let's bring this right back, because what the hell was that from Cody Begg? Cody Begg says he's gonna cave in the skulls of Lux7, Christian Vega, and Shane the Gamer here tonight. That's a threat! Now, Cody, like, I've said this to Goldberg, and I'm gonna say this to you. You can't do that! You can't do that, Cody! It's not allowed! You can't go around caving people's skulls in. But Cody Begg does what he wants to do. That's for damn sure. And this man right here, Raul Kapar, does what he wants to do. And he wants to take on the TV champion. One of his guys he has actually been fond of for a while is holding on to the TV title. Kevin Langhoff, the new TV champion, who took the title away from Crossbow last week in a very shocking turn of events. We thought Crossbow was well on his way to being another man to successfully defend the TV title 5 separate times. However, that didn't happen. But tonight, Kevin Langhoff has a tough, tough task in Raul Kapar. And here they are. Take a good look at your new television champion. Joined to the ring by the It's Nightcore, Kevin Langhoff, the new foundation. Take a good look at them, boys and girls. These guys could very well be some new kids on the block that could change the rankings, if you will. Like, I know they're not that new, but they have always been held in the tag team division, haven't they? What would happen if these two united and tried to move their way up in some singles action? You know, what, maybe one man helping the other along the way? I wonder how these two would fare. But right now, it certainly looks like Kevin Langhoff looks very comfortable with that TV title. We got ourselves a bam, 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 bam. It's a botch guy up in here. How you doing, man? Funny story. Literally 30 seconds before I went live, I got a phone call from Botch Guy. It was very sweet. He just wanted to catch up and talk because we're friends, and I like catching up with him. But I felt like a bad friend because I'm like, yeah, okay, hi, yeah, I gotta go. I gotta go, man. I'm sorry, I gotta go. We'll catch up soon, Bachi.
Introducing the challenger from Mumbai, India, weighing in at 232 pounds, the Prodigy. Introducing the champion from Green Bay, Wisconsin, weighing in at 225 pounds, he is the WWE Television Champion, Kevin
Langhoff from Green Bay, Wisconsin! All right, everyone, drop that like on this video. Make sure you're subscribed. It's our first match of the evening. And if you wish to support this channel, you can always drop a super chat donation or you can become a member here. This channel is running wild. Let's go, everyone. Ring that bell and take a good look at those two. Oh, my God. No, 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 no. The last breath already. Last breath from Raul Kapoor. That might be enough. Oh, my God. Oh, kick out by Kevin Langhoff. Raul Kapoor hit his best move to open up this match, and that's not where Kevin wants to be. If you're Kevin Langhoff, that is not where you want to be. Kevin Langhoff, though, finds a way to reverse that one and then takes him by the waist and knocks him down into the mat. Raul Kapoor in the live chat is not a fan of that start, even though he hit his best move. Oh, no. Guys, I think Kevin Langhoff is about to go. Oh, yeah. Here he goes. He's going insane, isn't he, boys? He's just going to throw Raul Kapoor off the ropes 3 times. Down goes Kapoor. And is it going to be a fourth? Off the ropes again. Raul hit for a fourth. Good Lord, Kapoor sent high into the air. That's like 7 feet in the air that he just fell down 4 separate times. But Kapoor finds his way back into this match and drives an elbow into the chest of Kevin Langhoff. Now back up to their feet. He goes for a back elbow, does Kapoor, but he gets caught into a side slam suplex. And take a look at that. Kevin Langhoff just going to start to work on the right arm of Raul Kapoor. But you also have to remember, Raul has not only Ahmed on the outside, but he has Thunderstorm. Oh, shoot! Kevin Langhoff with a big-time Langhoff lariat. And that's a move that can decapitate you regardless of who you are. Big Bad Ahmed could have his head taken off. So could Raul Kapoor with one swing of that arm. Oh, again! Another Langhoff lariat into the cover. Count of two and a kick out by Kapoor. What a start to the show, and Ahmed sticks his ugly face into this match. Raul Kapoor takes full advantage. No, come on. Not like this, ref. You got to get a control of this match. You got to get control of these people at ringside. Kapoor with some capital punishment to Kevin Langhoff. And I don't know what Raul is thinking. What? Raul? What do you want to do? I think Kapoor's just going to get a breather. He needs a moment to catch his breath, maybe. I don't know. Oh, do you see Ahmed trying to block Langhoff from getting to Raul? Instead, though, Langhoff goes right after him, and Raul just punches him right back over the barricade. Kapar is like, dude, you fell right into my trap. You activated my trap card. And Kevin Langhoff's like, ha ha ha, I reversed your trap card with my trap card, and I throw you to the ground. But Raul Kapar's like, no, we're gonna chain link this one, and I'm gonna play another trap card on your trap card because I'm back in control. And then slamming him off the hardest part of the ring. It's a lot of trap cards that were just played, apparently. Now into the ring, Raul Kapar goes. Here he goes again. Off the ropes, Kapar, oh. What's turnabout is fair play, isn't it, ladies and gentlemen? Kapar throwing Langhoff into the air, but now Raul right back after Kevin Langhoff, throws him over the top rope. Wait, Raul, Kapar? Raul, oh no! Spike DDT time! Spike DDT! Goodness me, ladies and gentlemen! Wait, what? It's false count anywhere! No! What the hell? Since when was it false count anywhere? Hold up, what? Raul Kapar, whoa. Was that match actually announced as false count anywhere? This, hold up. That makes no sense. Kevin Langhoff just got screwed. There is no way in hell that match was false count anywhere. Is, no. I'm just being too much of a conspiracy theorist, right? There's no way Scott is in the back pocket of Raul Kapar, is there?
Here is your winner and new WWE Television Champion, The Prodigy.
Oh, whoa. Cody Bag, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, he said that he was going to attack Lux 7, Christian Vega, and Shane the Gamer caved their heads in. And Cody Bag just struck him right in the side of the head. Lux 7, no. Oh, my God, Cody. That's a limo. Cody Bag throwing him up against the limo. That's Steve Taylor's limo. Cody, no. Throwing him up on the hood of the limo. Has him in a powerbomb position. Cody, stop it, dude. Oh, my God. What else is Cody Bag thinking? Cody has him and just slams him up against the edge of the limo as well. We got to get some security out here. Someone's got to stop this. Anyone. Like, where's Christian Vega? Where is Shane the Gamer? No, Cody, no, chair! Another shot! Cody Bang, stop it, man! Look at the blood on his hands! Telling him to get up, this is... Cody, don't do it again! Don't do it again! Don't you dare! Don't you dare! Oh, another dark hole kick! Cody Bag calling for the dark hole kick. Another boot to the face. This is enough, Cody. Oh my God, Luck's not going to be able to walk. Three kicks to the face.
Introducing first, from Raleigh, North Carolina, Sophia.
Holy everyone, Cody Bag is making everyone take notice that what he said earlier tonight wasn't just words. He is actually following through on what he said. Cody Bag is attacking. Well, I mean, I'm assuming he's trying to systematically destroy this group. He's trying to take him out one by one, and it looks like Lux 7 has been taken out. But ladies and gentlemen, this right here is Bulletproof Barajas, Sofia Barajas. And she is going to be in tag team action. Tornado tag team action, I believe. Alongside of Pam M. Hit her music. The number one contender for the women's title. It's Pam M.
And her partner from Cheyenne, Wyoming, Pamela.
It's the huggable one. So Pam M, your number one contender for the women's championship, is going to get her opportunity against Rebecca Helfritz next week at CMU Halloween Havoc. Are you excited for the Halloween show? I certainly hope so. But ladies and gentlemen, if you are enjoying the show, do me a favor, drop a like on this video. It helps me out a ton. And also, my friends, if you're enjoying the show that much, please consider dropping a Super Chat donation. Any little bit is appreciated. Or you can become a member to support this video on a monthly basis, if you wish. Since we have all the theme songs playing in the background, there is absolutely no ad revenue earned from this once we are done being live. And the stuff that we get during live, obviously, is very little. So if you wish to show your support, that's how. But let's get talking about this match. Oh boy. Just give me 1 second here, guys. I've got to reply to a text message. And here comes Rebecca Helfritz.
And her partner from Scottsdale, Arizona, the world women's champion, Rebecca.
Okay. So, Rebecca Helfritz, your women's champion, is here. And we got ourselves an actual $5 donation from
a mini.
How you doing, man? Good to see ya. Good to have ya. So, let's run this thing and let's see what it is you've got to say. Yes, Tornado Tag Team Action.
Just FYI, I'm a 5-time October boss champ. No one's taking it this time. I won't job this time.
Okay, so you guys can get your bets in now by doing either bet Pam 5 to 10 or bet Kayla 5 to 10. Here we go. And yes, Amity, you're a 5-time boss battle champion. Yes, you are, my man. I hope that you get it this month. You deserve it. King of Fade in the live chat says, still has yet to see that bald head of hers. Perhaps she's waiting for her hair to grow back to take the hood off. Interesting, interesting theory. Big Tiger is asking me a lot about, can we do spin the wheel, make the deal for all title matches at Halloween Havoc? No, my friend, no. I don't know if I'm interested in copying everything that WWE does per se. It's a cool idea. I don't want to sound like this is a cop-out. A lot of extra work. And I'm just not quite there at the moment, I think, in terms of time being able to do it. But let me think about it. It's just not likely. Maybe for another time we can do like a spin the wheel thing if the pay-per-view is centered around that. It's not what I've been building to, so I think you can understand why we're not going to go through with it. So I guess no King of the Ring, Queen's Crown either. I don't know, my friend. I don't know. Maybe we'll do something different. There's a lot of concern with the future of the CMU right now, guys, if I'm just being honest, okay? A lot of concern with the future of it. Kayla Bernstein now starting to spin around Sophia Barajas and throws her down to the mat. And now Pam M gonna go right after Rebecca Helfritz as well. Look at this. Kayla Bernstein. Giant German followed it up with a lariat. Down goes Barajas. And then a cutter from Pam M too. Rebecca Helfritz, that might be enough. Into the cover, but broken up by Kayla Bernstein. Oh, and then a right hand. Big time right hand from Kayla Bernstein. Knocks back Sophia and Pam M. Now Sophia has her up on the shoulders of Kayla Bernstein and then knocked down into the mat. Now here comes Pam M with a big punch to the side of the head of Rebecca Helfritz. Sophia Barajas, what is this? Sophia, oh, go to sleep! Go to sleep, delivered! Rebecca Helfritz has her up on her shoulders. Into the cover goes Barajas. One, two, Hellbreaker delivered. Kick out by Bernstein. No, down into the cover goes Helfritz. But then a kick out right there. Broken up, I should say, by Barajas. Barajas now going right after Rebecca Helfritz. Back elbow delivered. Two back elbows delivered. Now right back after her. And a jawbreaker delivered to the side of the head as well. That doesn't make sense. Right to the jaw. The jaw's not on the side of the head, is it? Sophia Barajas gonna take Kayla Bernstein, her rival, and send her right over the top rope. What's the game plan with WWE 2K19 moving to WWE 2K22? Probably around that time we're gonna be trying to move any WWE 2K stuff on this channel over to Con Games, I would imagine by that point. So I wouldn't be surprised if WWE 2K22 saw the move of the CMU from here to Con Games. There's a lot that I have to figure out in terms of memberships along the way. I would have to figure out like a grace period as well. There's a lot to think about, unfortunately, so I don't have the answer for you right now. Kayla Bernstein now gonna send Sophia Barajas back into the ring. And now a right hand there from Kayla Bernstein. What is this? Kayla, look at the strength. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? A military press above her head. Kayla Bernstein now going to try to make bulletproof tap out. Kayla's going for it. Double knees to the chest of Pam M as well. Look at these two working their opponents. But now, oh no! Oh my goodness. Big time drop kick there from Helfritz as well. Barajas with a punch to the midsection of Kayla Bernstein. Back up to her feet. And Helfritz now going to run wild on Pam M. Kayla Bernstein, high angle power bomb. Oh my God. Bernstein bomb delivered. Drags her back. Jawbreaker there from Helfritz. Helfritz has her up. This is game over. One. Two. Oh my God! They beat her! Hellbreaker as well to Pam M. Kayla Bernstein and Rebecca Helfritz just beat Bulletproof Barajas and Pam M. Wow, that was hectic. The former tag team together, I think we called them the Baldies, didn't we, or something like that, I don't know. Something along those lines. These former tag team members work together tonight to overcome the odds. What a match. Lots more to come, though.
Here are your winners, Bernie and Rebecca.
Mr. Tornicane, I got a deal for you. You see, I'm kind of bored tonight, and I really don't feel like fighting anyone. Not really. I just want to see someone get punched in the face. Mainly you. So, tell you what. If you can beat my stooge, Brandon Harbin, then I will finally agree to face you next week at Halloween Havoc. However, if you lose, you will never, and I mean ever, get to face me one-on-one again. You got it? Take it or leave it, Mr. Grand Slam. What's it gonna be? We await you in the ring. Oh, so there's a challenge here, guys. It looks like, yes, he is. It's the Stooge!
And from New Orleans, Louisiana, weighing in at 227 pounds, Brandon
Harbin, the Stooge, has arrived, and he is going to go one-on-one against Mr. Tornicane tonight. Now, if Tornicane is able to defeat Brandon Harbin, he will get an opportunity next week at Halloween Havoc against Hunter Hand. However, if Tornicane does not beat Brandon Harbin, then guess what? Mr. Tornicane will never, and I mean ever, be able to face Hunter Hand one-on-one ever again. So one more time, the stipulation is, if Brandon Harbin loses, Mr. Tornicane faces Hunter Hand. Brandon Harbin wins, Mr. Tornicane never gets to face him again. Mr. Torn in the live chat says this will be a piece of cake. Faye says Brandon is going to receive a claymore to the skull. Ultimate prediction, expect to be correct. See? Cue his music. And here comes.
And his opponent from Cameron, North Carolina, weighing in at 260 pounds. Hurricane.
His name is Mr. Tornicane. Tornicane. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This match is officially underway. Who do you think will win? We have your bets available in the live chat. So do either bet Torn or bet Harbin right here in live chat. It ain't exactly a tornado. It ain't exactly a hurricane. But it's a bird. It's a plane. It's a tornicane. And Mr. Cody Bag, how you doing, buddy? How you doing? I hope you're doing wonderful today. What you up to, man? Oh, there's a chop to the chest from Brandon Harbin, the Stooge, and remember the former minion of darkness to Cody Bag. He has chosen his path, and he has chosen it alongside of Hunter Hand and the CEO Con. It's quite a disgusting path, if I'm being honest, but the Stooge is able to probably get a handsome paycheck as a result. Oh, he went for a spinning back fist. However, he missed that one. Drop toe hold. Down goes Mr. Tornikane. Spinning back fist again. He missed it two times in a row. His accuracy, not too good, is it? And now, gonna be lifted up and down into a powerbomb. Into the cover, but a kick out by the Stooge. Yeah, Cody, you had an absolute, well, there's no else to say it. You destroyed Lux 7 earlier tonight. You really did. And then down goes Brandon Harbin, thrown to the mat again. You can see Hunter Hand kind of wincing in the background. It's difficult to watch, I understand. And then now throwing Harbin all the way down to the ground for a second time. So proud of his work, but the Stooge kicks him in the face. Harbin right back up to his feet and is going to send Tornikane hard into the corner, and down he goes. Again for a second time, up and over and right by Hunter Hand. Is Hunter Hand going to lay his hands on him? Hunter, dude, you can't do that. Ref, Scott, come on, man. He can't touch him. That is outside interference. But Brandon Harbin now gonna go right to work after Mr. Tornikane. Tornikane slides down his back though, and then a DDT plants him into the mat. Look at Hunter. Look at Hunter trying to distract Mr. Tornikane, getting really close to him. But Tornikane's like, nah, I'm not gonna let that be the end of me, as he slams Harbin on the hardest part of the ring. Hunter Hand. Cody Begg says, just wondered if the card is correct. Yes, it is, my man. Yes, it is. If you're looking for a match that you had, it wasn't a match. It was a backstage moment. Headbutt there. Countered. Kicked right there to the midsection. Here comes Brandon Harbin. Up and over. Code Red delivered. He might have enough here. Count of two. Kick reversed. Oh, my goodness. Into the cover. Count of two. Reversed again. Back down he goes. Another count of two. Back and forth they go. The Stooge and Tornikane. Back and forth again. And still no one able to pick up the victory. Goes for a headbutt. Reversed there as Harbin rolls around. Deep arm drag. Down goes Tornikane. And a stomp there right to the chest. But Tornikane finds his way right back up. You're right, it's reverse city up in here. But I think Tornikane has had enough, everyone. I think he's had it. There's a couple of punches right to the face, a stomp to the midsection, and Tornikane now telling him to get up. This might be it. This might be the end. Tornikane has him on his shoulders. Brandon Harbin planted down with some white noise. Oh, but Hunter Hand getting involved. Hunter Hand got involved. And Mr. Tornikane going to be sent over the top rope by Brandon Harbin again. And to the floor he goes. That moment distraction allowed Brandon Harbin to get back into this thing. Now what is Brandon Harbin looking for? He's having a little bit of a twitch moment. But a back elbow there from Tornikane stops him in his tracks. Kick reversal there from Brandon Harbin. Off the ropes. Drop kick. No one home. Kick. Sidestep. Big heel kick from Harbin. And Harbin has to go to the sky. He's got that moon stomp. He's got to be able to hit it. Brandon Harbin now. No, caught again. Harbin up into a gut buster. That has to hurt. And I think Mr. Tornikane's going to go to the skies instead. Goodness me, a big time elbow drop. Tornikane rocked him. And now back into the corner. Wait, he was thinking Claymore for a second, but instead I think he's going to do something else. What the hell are you going for, man? Another gut-wrench bomb. Tornikane lifts him up. Here it is. Headbutt delivered. Ho, ho, ho. Good night, Stooge. Brandon Harbin is down. Tornikane. No, sidestepping him right there. Harbin moved out of the way. However, there's a right hand. Blocks the chop. The Stooge fires right back. No, Harbin caught again. No, 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 no. Pile driver. You're going to break his damn neck if you do that. Poor Brandon Harbin. The pile driver puts him down. Kick to the midsection. Future shock. DDT. It's over. Big win for Mr. Tornikane. And it's going to be Hunter Hand versus Mr. Tornikane in like 1 week's time. CMU Halloween Havoc is right around the corner next week, everyone. I'm looking forward to it, and I hope you guys are as well. Drop that like if you're pumped for Halloween Havoc. Congratulations, Tornicane. Congratulations. And watch that beautiful Future Shock DDT. Don't get much nicer than that, does it? Whoa, my man, Tevin Walker. How you doing,
Here's
buddy?
Your winner,
thank you so much. 25 bomb, my man. Tornicane, though, proud of his work as he goes on to face Hunter Hand. Wait a second, Hunter Hand. Oh, no. I wondered if he was going to do something like this. Hunter Hand, come on. Claw. Slam from Hand. Wait. What's he doing? Hunter. No. Oh, my. Don't tell me. Is Hunter Hand about to bring a table? This is Mr. Tornicane's greatest enemy. This is his greatest freaking enemy. To the back of his head. Oh, my God. Trying to chop his head off. Mr. Tornicane hates tables. And ladies and gentlemen, I think this is a message. This absolutely has to be a message. Is Hunter Hand trying to say he wants a tables match? Oh my God. Claw slam from Hand. And I think he's about to put him through some lumber. Hunter Hand has him up. Hunter Hand with a power bomb through the table. Hand puts him to rest. You know, I fought hard tonight. I fought hard and it just wasn't enough. Maybe the result will be the same next week. But maybe it won't. I know everyone is counting me out before this match between me and Rebecca even happens. But so what? I'm a former women's champion myself. Yeah, sure, it was like 3 years ago, but I've done it before. I can do it again. So Rebecca, bring your best, because I sure as hell won't give up. Oh! Oh, come on! Also, Rebecca Helfritz, what the frig was that about? You can't just go around backstage, have a steel chair in your hand, and just clock everyone over the top of the head just because you want to. But everyone, this is the regime. Thunderstorm, Ahmed are gonna go 2-on-2 against some former tag team champions in the name of the Bad Pants. Hey, Syntax, how you doing? It's the Bad Pants!
And their opponent, at a combined weight of 468 pounds, Nathan Barker and Carol!
This is the Bad Pants, former tag team champions. By the way, once again there, Tevin Walker, thank you so much, my man. I really appreciate that. So, this one is going to be a tough task for the former tag team champions. I mean, this is the very first time that we have seen Ahmed and Thunderstorm wrestle together. They have never tagged together, but this is going to be a difficult one, man. These two behemoths going up against these former tag team champions. Like, you know, both of them possess skills. Both of them have something that the other team doesn't have. But the one thing that Ahmed and Thunderstorm do have that Bad Pants don't is the television champion at their side. Raul Kapar is at ringside for this match. Oh, Tornicane, buddy. Tornicane, I am so sorry to hear about that. My deepest condolences. I hope you're okay, my man. Remember the good memories. I'm so sorry, buddy. My deepest condolences. And everyone here in this live chat, I hope you can pass your condolences along to Mr. Tornicane during these tough times. I'm so sorry, buddy. We're thinking of you tonight. All right, so let's roll this donation. We actually have another donation at this moment from Syntax Air. How you doing, dude? He says, Con, it's me, Max, from the Conman server. I know who you are, dude. Good to see you, man. You say it's totally not your first time watching the CMU. Well, you totally haven't been missing out for 3 years. Wait a second, what? Holy cow, double super kick from the Bad Pants. The Bad Pants just drove their boots into the jaw of Ahmed. And Ahmed is down right now. He's struggling, and this might not be good for this big behemoth. Let's roll this 25 bomb. And we have Syntax dropping his 10. Thank you very much. As Thunderstorm has officially been tagged in. Right hand there, attempted from Harold Garner, but Thunderstorm knocks him right back down into the mat. If you're Thunderstorm, you want to stay on this offense, don't you? Throws him down. Right hand again to Thunderstorm. This is a bad dude who is signed with the regime and a big boot as well. Puts down Harold Garner. Tevin Walker says, let's go, Bad Pants. Yes, Tevin, are you looking forward to your match against Villain next
week? Con, it's me, Max, from the Conman server.
Raul says Thunderstorm returns to action for the first time in bloody ages. Has been a little bit, hasn't it? Off the ropes. Oh, another big boot from Thunderstorm. This guy is a menace in that ring. And now what is this he's going for? Thunderstorm? Oh, come on. Is this the stalling suplex? We've seen this before from this man. He's gonna now put him down. All that blood rushing to the head. It might very well be enough. Into the cover. Count of two. Broken up there by Nathan Barker. But Nathan. Oh no, dude. Oh my god. Oh my god. Did you see him just get flung? Nathan Barker just whipped over his head like a sack of potatoes. Into it. Thunder Green delivered. These are former tag team champions. Cover two. They just destroyed the former tag team champions. Are you kidding me? The Bad Pants just got wrecked. Is the tag team division now on notice? Wow. It certainly seems that way. That's a message if I have ever seen one. The Bad Pants, former tag team champions, just got wrecked.
Here are your winners, the Tank, Ahmed, and Thunder Storm.
Wow. Oh, what? Who is that? That's true knowledge. Oh my God, that's C Wrestling. No way, guys. This is the breakout finals here. This is what's supposed to happen. These two are supposed to face next week at Halloween Havoc, and it looks like True Knowledge is gonna try to get some upper hands before the match next week. True No, no. Oh my God, that's concrete. That's concrete. Oh my God, no. Vertebreaker on the concrete. C Wrestling dropped right on those cat ears. Not again. Not again. No, no, no. In catering, where's Botch Guy? Oh my God, he might have just killed him. No, C Wrestling's moving. Oh my God, thank goodness, everyone. C Wrestling is still moving.
Making his way to the ring from Great Falls, Montana, weighing in at 256 pounds, Casey.
So next week, everyone, the finals of the CMU Breakout Tournament are official. It is going to be C Wrestling versus True Knowledge at Halloween Havoc. This one is going to be good. You do not want to miss it, everyone. The CMU Breakout Tournament finals. And remember, the winner of the tournament gets either a shot at the Intercontinental Championship or the United States Championship. A mid-card title opportunity is on the line. But this right here, my friends, is Casey Wood, who recently has been at a moral crossroads. After 2 weeks ago, two weeks ago, when we saw Anthony Daniel take the members' championship away from Casey Wood, we wondered how Casey would react, and he did so by asking for his rematch 1 week later. Last week, we saw Anthony Daniel spare Casey Wood. He says, "Sometimes I am a god, and sometimes I can make people die." But he decided to let Casey Wood live, and here is Casey having to fight another day, but this time he is going up against the Pet Project. The Monster, Stephen B.
And his opponent, accompanied by Anthony Daniel. And from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 412 pounds, Stephen B.
So Anthony Daniel flanking him from behind. He is the members' champion. And this menace here is going one-on-one with Casey Wood. If I'm Casey, I'm loading up those steel boots with all the steel I can find, because he is going to need every bit of help he could possibly need to defeat Stephen B. This guy is a mammoth, and he is going to try to survive tonight, is Casey Wood. But remember also, Anthony Daniel said if Casey Wood ever wants to talk, he would love to chat with him again. Remember, if you're enjoying the show, make sure you leave a like on this video, also making sure you are subscribed to the channel. And if you would like to, you can always drop a little super chat donation to support the show. Referee, ring that bell. Here we are. All right, we have Anthony Daniel dropping a 7-bomb. Thank you very much, Anthony. I appreciate your support. And he is asking me the following question. I will answer it after the boom.
You know it's all about the boom!
Hey Con, ever thought about doing the CMU at night like this normally? It almost feels like a TV show, Just a thought.
Yeah, Anthony Daniel, you know, I've thought about it many times. I've thought about it in terms of viewership. I thought about it in terms of how much easier it would probably make my day. The only thing that I have going against it is that Thursdays are a pretty special day to me and Becca. We usually have date nights on Thursdays. It's usually the one night a week where I can sit down with her and, you know, like after a long day of work for her, we can actually, you know, watch a TV show, watch a movie together. Just, it's a night for our relationship, and it's not something I wish to get rid of unless I absolutely have to, right? It's not something that I wish to move away from, I think. So it's a difficult answer, right? Because yes, view-wise, viewership-wise, community-wise, all of it, it would be better for the show to air at this point because it's when you guys are on YouTube, right? But it's difficult. Difficult to work around, for sure. Casey Wood, though, starting with a throat chop there. Been working on the boobs. Lux7 says, can you accept my friend request on Discord? I can try, my man. I've got about 700 requests over there on Discord. I have not accepted a single person other than like mod staff in Discord. So let me take a look, man. C, D, E, F, G. I don't know my ABCs. There it is. Lux7. Beautiful. There you are. Oh, what was that? I believe that was Stephen B going for a 7-foot bomb, but look at Anthony Daniel. Anthony Daniel getting right up there in the face of Casey Wood, and that's going to allow Stephen B to get back inside this ring. But Casey Wood, oh, whoa, the power. How the hell did he do that? Casey Wood just sent him flying. Are you kidding me? Casey is not going to let up now. Drop kick to the back. Stephen B is in trouble, everyone. Oh, the big ass boot. Big ass boot from Casey Wood. He's got him right where he wants him. Lining him up for the lumber boot. Here it comes. Lumber boot, no. Blocked into a hard clothesline. Stephen B signaling the end now. And I can see why. Stephen B with a clothesline over the top rope and down to the floor. Anthony Daniel now gonna lift him up. Stephen B is blocking the referee's eyesight. He didn't even see Anthony Daniel do that. No, now Stephen B working on the leg. Looking to lift him right back up. Casey Wood is in trouble. Blocks it though. Casey Wood, a suplex of his own. That's 400 plus pounds that he just got over his head. Now back up to his feet, Casey Wood trying for something big. No, another block. Down he goes. Casey Wood caught in the heel hook. He might snap his damn leg. It's a big dude. But now Casey boots him right in the face. That'll break up any pinfall, any submission hold, anything like that, because a boot to the face hurts. And now Casey again with his hands in the sky goes to kick him in the chest with the steel-toed boots, but he gets hit with a dragon screw leg whip. Stephen B stomps right there on the midsection. What is he trying to call for? Stephen B going for something big. However, Casey Wood reverses that one. Very good matchup here. Back and forth action we have gotten so far. Trying to go for a clothesline is Casey Wood. Kick, DDT, down goes Stephen B. And then works on the right arm, lifting him up by the neck. Casey went for the big ass boot. He missed that one. Right hand there, no one home. And Stephen B again sent over the top rope. Casey is bringing the fight. I'm actually pleasantly surprised. Oh no, kick right there from Stephen B. And Stephen wants to get back inside the ring. He's not going to risk a countout loss. Now Stephen, oh, thrown down into the mat. I do, Casey Wood. Do you remember what I replied with when I said we will just have to wait and see? We will just have to wait and see. That's my same answer right now, my man. But thank you very much for the $5 donation. Into the cover, count of two, kick out by Stephen B. However, I believe Casey Wood is busted wide open. Yes, he is. I see blood coming down the face of Casey. Casey goes for the big ass boot again. Stephen B, though, gonna catch him. Oh, no, no! Holy cow! Just launched him over his head. Into the cover, but Casey kicks out. I can't tell if that was a rope break or not. Stephen B, though, driving his knee into the side of his head. Oh, Casey is in trouble. In a lot of trouble. No, reverse there by Wood. Shoves him down. How is Casey still fighting? This is really incredible. For another big ass boot, but reversed again by Stephen B. Uppercut knocks him into the mat. Up to his feet again. Stephen B. reversed one more time. Clothesline, no one home. Stephen B. missed that one. Instead, he's going to send him off the ropes. Back elbow, misses that. Throat chop, no! Oh my god, no! 7 foot bomb! You're not waking up from that, Casey! Stephen just wrecked Casey Wood as well. That's a long way down. And 7 feet being driven into the mat. And Anthony Daniel has to be very...
Here is your winner, Stephen B.
Very happy with his pet project's work. Fate, I'm not joking when I say you win tonight, or what I did to you last week will be the least of your worries. Got it? Win or else. Win or else, he says. Oh no, who is serving a fate facing?
Making his way to the ring from Dover, Delaware. Weighing in at 196 pounds, Youngblood.
Youngblood has arrived, and this man looks a little different, walking a little different. You can tell he doesn't have the same pep in his step that he used to. Almost as if some of the joy, some of the energy, some of the spunk was beaten out of him last week. Serving a feint. Feint has arrived. Lux7 says, I get to go home now, 10.5 hours later. Dude, bet you're looking forward to getting home. But who's serving a fate facing? Oh no! Oh my! It's the era of Raw! Oh, damn. Servant of fate. Oh, God. Steve Taylor is... Oh, he's totally going to beat your ass, isn't he? There's not a chance in hell Servant of Fate is beating this guy. Not a chance. He has to win this match or else. Or else what? Or else you'll get a finger up your bum. I don't know. I hope not. Hope that's not what the or else is. But Casey Wood, thanks for the five bomb.
Burn it down!
Ring the bell, and here we go. Robert Briggs serving a fate. Oh my god, serving a fate, almost just like accepting. Just accepting his demise.
Conman, do remember what I say earlier about me and Stephen B. and Anthony.
I do, my man, I do. We will see. Thank you so much for the support. C Wrestling says, dude, How do you even have a voice after Crown Jewel? I'm a maniac, aren't I? I don't understand how I can stream for 5 hours and then go for another two here tonight, screaming at the top of my lungs. That's 7 hours. Can you guys picture speaking, like, if you have an 8-hour workday, can you picture screaming for seven of them? That's what I'm doing today. I don't understand how. Uh-oh, big Enziguri there from Servant of Fate. Ooh, reversal. Back inside the ring he goes. Now Robert Briggs follows suit. Also, by the way there, C Wrestling, if you would like to, there was a bit of a segment involving your character earlier tonight. It was a behind-the-scenes, not a behind-the-scenes, a backstage moment if you want to rewind and see that. Wait a second, Servant of Fate? Fate? No way, what? Are you kidding me? Big time murderplex. A giant superplex to the outside, and Servant of Fate, is he gonna, oh, he's gonna go back and forth. You're kidding me. Servant of Fate just showing the world how much energy this man has. He's gonna be like, he might as well just be laughing maniacally while he's doing this. Just going back and forth like a little joker. Now here we go, throws Robert Briggs back inside the ring. How is Briggs in trouble? Robert, I think Servant of Fate was going for the Fate Lock. Instead though, Briggs couches, Oh no, Briggs Buster delivered into the cover, count of two and a kick out. Because that's what I do at 1 a.m. That's hilarious, see? I love that. I actually love that. Wait, no. Briggs. I know what Robert wants to hit, ladies and gentlemen. Briggs is thinking spear. Oh, but Fate's going to get right back up to his feet. Oh my God, Briggs went for a choke slam. However, Fate throws him into the corner, runs into a back elbow. That's not good. Oh no! Servant of Fate, you just got wrecked! Reverse choke slam. Down goes SOF, and more like SOS. Fate's done. Fate is done. And he had to be hurting after last week as well. There is not a chance in hell Servant of Fate was anywhere near 100% after the dastardly evil attack from Steve Taylor. But that's not good, guys. That's not good for Servant of Fate. Steve Taylor warned him. He said, you have to win or else. And if I'm Servant of Fate, I am looking over my shoulder right now because I don't have a damn clue what Steve Taylor has in mind.
Here is your winner, Robert Briggs.
Briggs, the winner. But I'm so worried for Servant of Fate. Oh, no. Yeah, I had the right. Oh, my God, guys. I was right being afraid. Here comes Steve Taylor walking slowly to the ring. He's got a freaking kendo stick. No. Oh, my God. Off the skull of his servant. Steve Taylor just rocked him. And now Taylor into the billionaire's toss. Steve Taylor, dude, enough, man. Enough. No. Put it down. Just walk away. Are you kidding me? Enough is enough, Steve Taylor. He's just going to whack him again. Is everyone in the back just going to let Steve Taylor do this? No one going to come and save Servant of Fate? Enough is enough, Steve Taylor. No. Oh my God, off the skull. Not again. No. Come on. Steve Taylor is destroying Servant of Fate. And if I'm Servant of Fate, I'm running. I'm trying to get out of there. But Steve Taylor just clobbered him in the back of the head. And not again, dude. Enough is enough. Enough is enough.
I think Servant of Fate is dead. He's not moving, man. Taylor, not again. Come on. Enough, Steve. Holy cow, man. How many more shots? Your point has been made. Not again. Come on. Billionaire's toss. And leaves him this time. Doesn't even tell him to go. Are you ready for a steel cage match?
Introducing first, from Anaheim, California, weighing in at 196 pounds, the Anomaly.
So today, everyone, this match, there is a lot on the line because Tevin Walker versus the Villain is going down next week at CMU Halloween Havoc. That match is happening. But the question is, who will be in their corners? Because this match, the losers will be banned from ringside during Villain's and Tevin Walker's world title match. Whoever loses has to stay in the back. You can escape the cage. You can win via pinfall or submission.
From Manchester,
you just
England,
have to win.
Weighing in at 200.
Here comes Retro Demand. And Amity was by his side as well. You guys know this trio. Amity, Tevin Walker, and Retro Demand, known as the heart and soul and spirit of the CMU. Raul Kapar says, Amity shouldn't even be in the main event scenes after I embarrassed him. But everyone, here comes a rapture. Here they come. Here is the rapture. No Villain by their side. Obviously, both Tevin Walker and Villain have to remain in the back during this steel cage match. But whoever climbs out of the cage or wins via pinfall or submission will be allowed to join either Tevin Walker or the Villain at ringside. Of course, if the Dark Side and Chaos win this match, they will join Villain. If Amity and Retro Demand win this match, they will join Tevin Walker. Oh, everyone, the music cuts. And when that music cuts, you know the rapture means business. Oh, this is going to be a good one. We're going to get some polls going for this one and some bets. So who will win is the question. It's either going to be Rapture, or it's going to be Amity and Retro. Here you go, guys. Bet Rapture or bet Retro. 5 to 10 con coins. Here we go. This match is officially underway. And it looks like Chaos is going to try to get out of this cage early on. But Retro Demand decides to play defense. I mean, you got to be keeping your head on a swivel during this match. Anything can happen. At any point, someone can climb out of the cage. And you also have to figure out strategy. Do you try to escape the cage before your partner? Because then you leave your partner in a 2-on-1 scenario. So a lot of strategy here, how you have to go about it. Oh, Retro Demand falls all the way down from the side of the cage, and a hard clothesline from Dark Side plants down Amity. Nightmare Inferno says, I'm ready to claim that IC title. Yeah, it sounds like we're going to get that rematch at Halloween Havoc. By the way, everyone, the card is set for next week's Halloween Havoc. Chaos is going to try to escape out of the cage here. But at some point here today, I will be giving you the card for next week's Halloween Havoc, okay? Pulling him down off the side of the cage was Retro Demand, and down goes Darkseid as well. Planted down by Amity, but it looks like Chaos is just going to stomp on Retro Demand and then maybe drive him right back down into the mat with a double hammer fist to the back. Amity with a drop kick to Darkseid. That didn't even phase him. Overhead belly-to-belly throw knocks him down. Kick right there. Elbow to the leg. Reversed. Oh my god, Darkseid's gonna plant a midi. Face first he goes. That's one of Darkseid's biggest moves, and I think he's looking for the Tongan death grip. Here he goes, going for the death grip. However, a midi counters that one. Kick right to the midsection. A midi with a drop kick, however, it doesn't knock him off his feet, and Darkseid just punches him in the face and follows it up with a clothesline. Retro to man, pile driver delivered to Chaos. That's a huge move to be hitting, and you're gonna see Darkseid try to get out of this cage, but Retro to Man plays defense, shoves his leg right there into the side of the cage again. Darkseid jumps on down, Retro to Man gonna take advantage, however, he kicks him in the midsection, DDT, down he goes. On the far side, though, Chaos is gonna try to escape this cage, but he can't quite get there. Retro to Man, a couple of punches to the back of the leg, and now Chaos is going to jump on down from the side, and Amity's going to try to escape this cage, but Retro to Man playing defense. Look at this. This is the strategy we talked about, and Retro to Man plants him down with a DDT. Look at this beautiful strategy. Retro to Man and Amity are going to try to get out of this cage. Beautiful strategy as Darkseid is watching Amity go over the top of the cage, and Retro to Man's gonna try to climb out of there as well. Retro to Man is on top of the cage, and Darkseid hammering away on Amity, but now Chaos is gonna try to bring him back inside the ring. Chaos with a right hand. Amity's gonna try to get over. What now? A right hand from Chaos. Darkseid, wait a second. Hang on, everyone. I think Chaos and Darkseid have decided to allow Amity to go out of the cage. They're going to try to break down Amity. Or sorry, they're going to try to... Yeah, I don't even know what I'm saying. English is difficult. Retro to Man is alone in the cage now with Darkseid and Chaos. But now take a look at Darkseid. He's now over top of the cage. Retro to Man hanging on for dear life. Amity is down on the floor. All Retro to Man has to do is get his feet to touch the floor in order for Tevin Walker to not have to deal with the Rapture at ringside. There's a shot as Chaos drags him down off the side. And I think Darkseid is about to escape this cage. Yes, he does, but we're now down to one-on-one. Retro to Man, reverse DDT right there to Chaos. And we're down to one-on-one. Retro to Man, though, waiting for him to get back up to his feet. Retro, super kick delivered! Retro to Man's gonna do it. Elbow drop right there to Chaos. Come on, get yours, Retro. Get yours, Retro. Wait a second, he turns around. No! Retro to Man, you idiot. You idiot, you had the match won. You had it won and you turned around and went for the splash and now run into some snake eyes. Chaos has you up. Chaotic driver. Retro to Man screwed himself. Retro had this match won. And he went for glory. He went for the end. And I think Chaos, everyone, has a large jump start. But now Retro to Man is back up to his feet. Retro to Man is moving. He's moving. He's almost there. No! Chaos gets down before Retro to Man can reach him. And it's going to be 3-on-1. For Tevin Walker next week. The Rapture is at ringside. need any lights on to see. These guys are a threat. Here comes Christian Vega.
Making his way to the ring from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, weighing in at 227 pounds, the WWE Champion, Christian.
What the hell is Cody talking about? Shane's secret. Someone else is after my title. I mean, everyone is after my title. Everyone. So what the hell is he talking about? It's got to be mind games, right? It has to be. Or is he talking about Shane? Wait. Is Shane coming for my title? Or is he talking about... No. It's got to be mind games. F me, man. These dang mind games are already working. No, there's no secret. Okay, focus on the damn match tonight, Christian. And then deal with this secret crap later. It seems like Cody Begg has gotten in the head of Christian Vega, hasn't he? But what is that secret? What's Shane's secret? I don't know, man. But here we go. We're about to get Christian Vega one-on-one against Dave. It's been a while since we've seen Dave. We have ourselves a $5 donation over here from Amity as well. Thank you, my man. He's not too fond of what happened in that match, though. Amity is seemingly blaming Retro Demand. Interesting. So after last week, remember, Dave Rua was attacked by some mysterious figure backstage. He believes it's Jason Barker. We believe it's Jason Barker. But no confirmation. That's slander. There's no proof. No proof. But we believe it's Jason Barker. The stunner, the southern slammer, the bald head. It looked a lot like Jason Barker. And Dave Rua vows to get to the bottom of this. Remember though, if you're enjoying this video, drop that like on it. Also making sure you are subscribed to the channel. I would love to see some names pop up there. And if you guys would like to, you can always support the channel by either becoming a member or by dropping a super chat donation. Here we go though. Dave Rua versus Christian Vega, one-on-one. This one should be fun to watch. And nice little backbreaker to start things off. Oh my God. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? I know this is no holds barred. I know there's no disqualifications, but come on. Come on. If that's not confirmation, I don't know what is. If that's not confirmation that it was Jason Barker, I don't know what else is. Into the cover, count of two off the Southern Stunner, but a kick out by Rua. Jason Booker, boo him, boo that man, boo! That man is a menace to the CMU. Your $1 million United States champion just does what he wants, and I've had enough of it. I've had enough of it, man. You know what? I've had so much of it. In fact, that I am going to announce now, right at this moment, in 2 weeks' time, Jason Barker, Dave Rua, it's going down for the United States title. I've had it up to here with you, Jason Barker. I've had it up to here. 2 weeks' time, Dave Rua, Jason Barker. Two weeks. Not next week. 2 weeks. now trying to pick his leg. And there's a stomp right there. And another stomp from Christian Vega. Three stomps right there to the side of the head of Dave Rua. As Dickhead Dave is down on the ground, goes to kick him in the face, but Christian Vega catches him with the Dragon Screw leg whip. However, Dave Rua back to work, back body drop, knocking down Vega, and a stomp there on the chest. Dave Rua, though, got reversed by Vega. And with the upcoming WWE title match, Christian Vega has to be wondering, what is Cody Begg planning? He says he planned on attacking him, kicking him in the skull, but we have seen no Cody Begg tonight on Vega. Uh-oh, though, Christian Vega, I think he's gonna send a message to the aforementioned Cody Begg to, ladies and gentlemen, it's over. Dave Rua falls victim to Vega, just like that. You have to thank Jason Barker for doing some early damage, but Christian Vega with the Vegas Clash is enough to put him away. Look at that stunner, and that all but confirms that it was Jason Barker versus Dave Rua. It was Jason Barker who attacked Dave Rua backstage. And in 2 weeks' time, we are going to get Jason Barker versus Dave Rua. Lux7 says, Cody Begg crushed my skull in. I'm in concussion protocol. I would say so. You were bleeding at the head. You got attacked by Begg. You got hit with four dark hole kicks and probably smacked in the head a few more times with a steel chair.
Christian Jason Barker.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match right here is gonna be a barn burner. It is time for Kevin Wade versus Grady Dose. The winner of this match will get to pick the stipulation for the tag team title match coming up next week at Halloween. Kevin Wade, one half of the Dynasty, one half of the greatest tag team to ever do it, going up against the current tag team champion, Grady Dose. Now it's time for these wild animals. Look at these boys.
And his opponent, accompanied by Ollie. And from Perry, Oklahoma, weighing in at 260 pounds, one half of the Bruiser.
So it's Grady to... Oh, what the hell? Oh my God, Cody Begg is attacking Christian Vega backstage. What in the blue hell is going on? Cody Begg just struck Christian Vega. He must have just come back through Gorilla. Cody Begg attacking him again. Oh my God, a second dark hole kick. No way, he said he was gonna cave his skull in. Cody Begg for a third time. Oh my God, Vega's down.
We need some medical help for the WWE champion. Christian Vega is out cold. We're supposed to see Cody Bag versus Shane the Gamer later, but it all of a sudden looks like Shane the Gamer is going to have no help. It looks like Shane is in a lot of trouble tonight in our main event, Extreme Rules. We'll see how that one goes. But now we have Kevin Wade versus Gradinos. Remember, the winner of this one gets to pick the stipulation in the tag team title match. Big heel kick there from Kevin Wade. Let's get around to these donations. Thank you very much, everyone. Amidi first.
Retro, are you kidding me? Come on, I haven't won in months now, and you do this. You screwed Tevin.
Wow. You screwed Tevin? Did Amidi really just say you screwed Tevin to Retro, who has done nothing but try to help? What?
Burn it down.
Like Thanos said, I'll do it myself.
I'll do it myself. Devin Walker, the Thanos of the CMU.
Burn it down.
What a spear from Wade. And right now, Gradinos is in a lot of trouble against a former tag team champion. One half of the greatest tag team to ever do it in the CMU. Devin Wade. Oh my god, caught.
As stated, Retro had a damn opportunity and screwed himself. Tevin, maybe you're better off without me? Tevin is a world-class talent, me? I'm not sure.
Wow, Amidi checking himself. Count a two off the spine buster and a kick out by Kevin Wade. But Amidi, it almost sounds like a lot of self-doubt is starting to creep into Amidi. Gradinos now lining it. No way! What? Kevin Wade just got caught! World's Strongest Slam! Is that the end of the match? Count a two, kick out by Wade. Right now, this has been a one-sided affair by Gradinos, and he almost just put Kevin Wade away with the World's Strongest Slam. Now up to his feet. Gradinos caught, and there's the Wade out. DDT, but Joseph Ali gonna stick his nose into this match. That's what the wild animals are doing these days, distracting their opponents, not necessarily playing by the rules. Taking the numbers advantage anytime they can, and right there distracting an opponent in the ring. I don't like these guys. I don't like their morals. I don't think that they're very nice people. The Dynasty aren't much better, but we gotta say this much. The Dynasty are proven here in the CMU, and Gradinos is gonna be sent for a ride up into the air. Some punches to the face from Kevin Wade. Gradinos is in trouble. Send him into the corner. What else is Kevin thinking? The master of the DDT. Looking to hit a tornado DDT on the outside. Wade! DDT to Gradinos. And you can hear the "This is awesome" chants from the fans. They love this matchup. Do you guys like this one? If you do, make sure you leave a like on this video. Also, making sure you are subscribed to the channel. There's a kick to the midsection from Wade. Another shot, back elbow delivered from Gradinos. Gradinos now sends Kevin Wade back inside the ring, and Grady's gonna follow suit. Try to go right after him. Lifts Wade up, what? Oh my god, what a power slam! Oh my god, is that gonna be enough? Wade is in trouble, count of two! Kick out by Kevin. Did you see the snap on that power slam? He lifted him up and snapped him right back down. But there's an uppercut from Kevin Wade into a... Oh my god, I think he just got countered. His knee was up. Gradinos just caught him with the knee. Kevin Wade was going for the spear. Gradinos, World's Strongest Slam. Kevin Wade in a world of trouble. Two. Oh my god. Gradinos just beat one of the greatest, or at least half of one of the greatest tag team champions of all time. That was tough to watch for Kevin Wade. I don't think I've ever seen anyone dominate Wade like that. I'm blown away. Brady Dose, my man, you are welcome to pick the stipulation for your tag team title match. I am getting my title back. Next week at Halloween Havoc, I am locked and loaded and aiming straight for the head of the new TV champion. Raul Kapar, you're my next target. Whoa! Crossbow Raul next week? TV title? Damn!
Making his way to the ring from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 249 pounds, Shane!
And now it's time for your main event of the evening! It is gonna be Shane the Gamer versus Cody Bag, Extreme Rules. Cody Bag has dismantled this group tonight. Christian Vega, Lux 7, and now Shane the Gamer has to go one-on-one against Cody Bag. It has been tough to watch. But I wonder what Shane's secret is. What is Shane's secret that Cody Bag seems to have over his head? Whatever it is, if it is anything, it's gotten into the head of Christian Vega. Are you ready? Your Prince of Darkness, it's Cody Bag. And this match is going to be, well, I don't know. The mood that Cody Bag is in, I do not expect a lot of big stuff from Shane the Gamer. In fact, I also wonder if Shane the Gamer is even willing to go 100% against Cody Bag. I think Shane, if there is a secret that Shane has that Cody Bag does know about, getting into the ring with Cody Bag has got to be one of the most, like, nerve-wracking things he could do. Yes, it's Extreme Rules. Maybe Shane the Gamer has a plan. Maybe he does. Maybe we'll see the plan fold out here tonight. But, like, Cody Bag has been all over the card today. Took out Lux 7 early on, seemingly has taken out Christian Vega, and now he's got Shane the Gamer in front of him. All with a WWE title match next week. It's insane. But here we go. Referee, ring the bell, and we're starting things off. Cody Bay going right after Shane the Gamer, takes him down. Oh, no, no, no! Oh my God, Christian Vega's okay! Christian Vega's back out here! This is Extreme Rules, ladies and gentlemen, and we've all of a sudden got ourselves a two-on-one scenario. But Christian Vega must not be at 100%. There is not a chance he is. Christian now swinging to the fences here and throws Cody Bay back inside the ring, and that did not take long. That did not take long for this to be a two-on-one scenario. Cody Bag is in trouble. Christian, go! Oh, what a reversal from Vega! Or to Vega from Bag. Bag, now right after Shane the Gamer, and he runs into a forearm. Down goes Cody Bag. Christian Vega tried to hit the Vegas Clash, but he couldn't hit it all the way. Oh, and now Vega takes down Cody Bag. And look at this man in this Extreme Rules matchup. Christian Vega just wrenches on the neck. But now, Cody's still fighting. Cody Bag's still fighting. Oh, but he eats a drop kick to the back of the head. Two on one. And now Christian Vega and Shane the Gamer just stomp away on a down Cody Bag. Wait a second, where's Vega going? What? Christian's just leaving? Whoa, why? Why, dude, where, why? You should just stay out here. What did you just leave for? Where did Christian Vega go? And now there's a stomp right there on the arm of Shane the Gamer. And now gonna work on the other arm. As soon as Vega leaves, Shane is in a lot of trouble. I mean, after last week also being attacked by Cody Bag, it's the question, is Shane the Gamer at 100%? Nice suplex putting down Cody Bag, the Prince of Darkness. And Shane's gonna try to lift him right back up, but a sweep of the legs from Cody Bag. Kick right there to the middle of the back. Cody lining it up, and there's a big knee to the side of the head. Cody! Dark Hole Slam! Oh my God, Shane, you're in trouble. But right back up to his feet, eats a punch. No! Oh my God! Channeling his inner John Cena! The Attitude Adjustment! Followed by a second Attitude Adjustment. Down goes Shane after the Dark Hole Slam. Two AAs, two. Ladies and gentlemen, Cody beat him like he's nothing. Unbelievable. Are you kidding me? Cody just put away Shane the Gamer like that. Like he was nothing. Proof right there that Shane the Gamer was nowhere near 100%. But Cody Bag, the Prince of Darkness, is focused, ready, and determined to bring back his WWE title.
Here is your winner,
next week,
Cody.
We see it go down.
It looks like I know your secret and kicked your ass. In fact, Shane, Luck and Vega all got their asses handed to them today. But one man still has something I need. Christian, you held onto that title long enough, and next week I bring it back to the shadows. Once more, the Prince will have
no!
his
crown. Oh my God, that's where he went. He left. You're kidding me. Vega! Clash on the chair! And that, my friends, is the CMU. Thank you very much, my friends, for watching. I really hope you guys did enjoy. We have something here from Grady Dose. He says the dynasty will be decimated inside a cage. Grady Dose, do you want it to be a cage fight or a steel cage match? Cage fight has to end via pinfall or submission. Steel cage match, you can escape the cage. Which would you like there, Grady Dose? And we're gonna now break the card to each and every single one of you. Yeah, a bit of a shorter CMU here today. Bit of a shorter one. The matches were quick. Nothing we can do about that. Still at our 10 matches, right? And I'm just waiting for Grady Dose
Once he tells me, we will be able to break the card down entirely. But I hope you guys did enjoy, seriously. Before we leave, make sure you leave a like on this video, also making sure you are subscribed. Gradido says cage fight. Awesome. So we are going to see a cage fight here. Wild animals, cage fight. Cool. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here is the card for next week. And I do not believe all of the stipulations are worked out on my card quite yet, but the actual matches themselves. Actually, just give me 1 second here. Yeah, that's that one. This is this one. Okay. Yeah, that's good. That's good. That's good. Yep. That one is gonna be this. Okay, sorry everyone, just 1 second, just figuring the rest out. Yeah, that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. Okay, here we go, guys. So, the card. The card is as follows. We will have the finals of the breakout tournament. It will be Sea Wrestling versus True Knowledge. We will see the TV title being defended as Raul Kapar defends his newly won TV championship against the former champion in Crossbow. Nightmare Inferno versus Antonio Coleman will be for the Intercontinental title, and it will be a no disqualification match. Mr. Tornicane versus Hunter Hand will be a tables match. Dynasty versus Wild Animals for the tag team titles will be a cage fight. Cody Begg versus Christian Vega for the WWE Championship. Rebecca Helfritz versus Pam M for the Women's Championship inside Extreme Rules. Sophia Barajas versus Kayla Bernstein. Jason Lyle versus Monte Prince for the Cruiserweight title. And then Tevin Walker versus the villain with the Rapture at ringside for the World Heavyweight title. That goes down next week, everyone. It is going to be a lot of fun. But until then, everyone, take care. Thank you very much for joining me for 7 hours of live streaming here today. It was a lot of fun, seriously a lot of fun. But now I'm going to go rest my voice, and I'm actually going to go watch Survivor. All right, everyone, take care. Have a wonderful rest of your night. I've been Con, and that was the CMU.